Welcome to another episode of Word of Life. We are in the fourth and final Sunday of Advent. Today's reading, taken from the Gospel of Luke, is from chapter 1. And the context is this. Angel Gabriel has just visited Mary and told her she will be overshadowed with the Holy Spirit and will bear a son who will be the Son of God. Not only that, the angel also told her her cousin Elizabeth, who was called barren, is in her sixth month of pregnancy. Hearing this news, Mary, the scripture tells us in today's reading, hurried to the hill country of Judea. When we hear this word hastened or hurried, we must not think of a physical hurrying or that she started running. No, it shows an eagerness on part of Mary. Not going to Judea to test out the words of the angel, but rather because she believed what the angel had said has come true. This journey from Nazareth to Judea would have been about 145 to 146 kilometers. It would have been an arduous journey, a difficult one, but yet Mary goes. Scripture further tells us that as she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth, two things happened. The child in Elizabeth's womb jumped for joy, and Elizabeth herself was filled with the Holy Spirit. It's very interesting, my dear brothers and sisters. Mary did not pray for them. Mary did not place her hands on them and bless them. Mary probably only greeted them with these words, Shalom, which means peace. And Elizabeth and her child in the womb was filled with the Holy Spirit. What a beautiful and consoling thought. When Mary greets us, we are filled with the Holy Spirit. And Elizabeth exclaimed in a loud voice, Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb. This is exactly the words that we use in the rosary when we say the Hail Mary. My dear brothers and sisters, our reciting of the rosary is repeating the words of Elizabeth filled with the Holy Spirit. And the same graces we believe what Elizabeth received, we shall also receive. Now Elizabeth tells us why she calls Mary blessed. She says, You are blessed because you have believed what God has promised will come true. Another thing to pay attention to. We are blessed not when we get a lot of material blessings. We are blessed when we listen to God's voice and obey it. Jesus said exactly this in Luke chapter 11 verse 28. So my dear brothers and sisters, we are at the threshold of Christmas. Christmas is just a few days away. Let us pray for the grace to Mary that just as she helped Elizabeth to be filled with the Holy Spirit, she will also help us. So that we too, like Elizabeth, can recognize the babe in the crib, not as just an ordinary child, but God Himself. Let us pray for this grace and ask Mary to pray for us too. Merry Christmas, and may God bless you and your family abundantly.